Hello, dear friends of the internet. It is me, Edward, of Dash.red, and today I'm going to install the Dash Electrum wallet on an Ubuntu box. This is a DigitalOcean droplet, a remote server. The version of Ubuntu is 16.04.5. And as you can see on the screen here, I have a command line interface, and I have my notes on what commands are needed to make this install work. So let's get going here. Okay, I'm going to install now the Ubuntu Mate desktop, and the reason is because the Dash install, the Dash Electrum wallet, and also the Core wallet seem to not work too well with a lot of VNC products. They do work okay with one VNC. The VNC is called Turbo VNC. I have been using in my installs version 2.1.2, and that works well with the Ubuntu Mate desktop, and so that is why I am using this desktop. Now, this is going to take about 10 minutes just to run, so I'm going to speed up the time. Here we go. Okay, now we are ready to do the next command. JQ is a program that the Electrum wallet can use from the command line. It is optional. Okay, so the next step is to install a VNC server that is compatible with the software that we're going to use. And when I mean that, what I mean to say is that the Dash software, both the Core wallet and the Electrum wallet, seem to only work in certain VNC environments. Now, VNC is if you're going to connect to a remote server and run a GUI program. If you have it on a local box, you don't even need to install this VNC. So this step right here is only necessary if you're going to be connecting with VNC. All right, so that takes care of that. And now we're going to do the commands to get the Dash Electrum wallet installed. Okay, apt-get update and apt-get install Dash Electrum. Okay, the Tor service is optional, but I'm going to install it anyway. Okay. Yes. Okay, and then service Tor start. And then VNC server. Okay, do you want a view-only password? No. Okay, now I need to make a change to my PuTTY session. I'm going to tunnel on port 5901 to localhost 5901. And then when I launch my VNC client, it should connect. And there we go. So we have a desktop We can launch a GUI in here. That's fantastic. So I right click the desktop, open in a terminal, and now I should be able to write to use this command. There you go. The wallet launches. So as we've seen before, you can create any wallet name you want. Okay, standard wallet, create a new seed, and there's my seed. So let me write this down. Okay, now I need to repeat that here. Next, okay, now I can put a password on this. The password is optional, but it's a good idea because it makes sure that only I can use the wallet that's installed on this machine. Okay, next, and there's the wallet. So just for fun, let's send some money from the Linux, or I should say, from my Windows machine to my Linux machine. So this is one of the receiving addresses on this. I don't know if that's actually visible to... No, it's not. So because that's not visible, what I can do is copy here, go here, open in terminal, make it VI. Paste it from here, and now from PuTTY I can cat that file, and then from here when I copy it I can open my Windows version and send directly to that wallet. So here I only have a little bit of dash in here. I think I can send that much. There. That was sent, and then on my other machine here, if I go to View, Show Coins, there, it just received the transaction, and you can see I have received some dash. So there you go. This wallet can be installed on Linux. Ubuntu works particularly well. I have tried to install it on Debian as well, but so far I haven't had quite as much luck. Remember that you do not need to install VNC unless you intend to connect remotely. If your machine is a local machine that you can hold in your hands, like a laptop or your desktop machine, then you won't need VNC at all, and you don't need to be concerned about the incompatibilities of the desktop environments, because it will install much easier and will work. Thanks for watching.